people that actually watch my videos, I am gonna, I don't know. Oh yeah, I should check what people say. What should I do on my video that I said on the video? I said comment down to tell me what I do next time.
Making a short video of two.
That video or do. So yeah, you want to do that, but the reason I'm making this video is that if you're seeing this video, which guy was it again? Oh yeah, it was
really freaking clever.
Really freaking clever. Really? The other really clever. And that's why I wanted to make this video, but I also need to. I'm gonna do stuff on this channel. Comment down below on this video what I should do with this channel. I just started off today, so I really got no idea. What? We're gonna react to this guy on how to become a star. Because I just started off literally today.
So I'm outside
and I just figured out that I can make them scream. Yay!
I forgot to say one thing. Subscribe to my channel and like.
It's been long awaited. This is a video that I promised you guys freaking months ago, and I just haven't gotten around to filming it because my life has changed so much this past year that, you know, 5 or 6 months ago when I filmed my part one to this, I was in a completely different stage in my life. I was thinking in like 1 month I would be able to film a part. that too. But then my YouTube life exploded, and I went from, you know, being this, like, just, I don't even know, like, I was just, yeah. I went from not knowing what's ahead of me to, actually, I still don't know what's ahead of me. But back then, I was like, you know, like, oh, maybe in a few weeks I can film part two. And literally, within that shift of weeks, my YouTube life just changed. So if you've been on my channel since about March-ish, you guys would know what this video is. If you are loyal and if you guys are new subscribers since March, this is going to be my How to Start a YouTube Channel part two. And I'm going to call this one How to Start a Successful YouTube Channel.
Yeah, let's learn how to.
I feel accomplished. Apparently, my tips in my last video really helped you guys because the comments were so genuine and nice, and you guys really liked it. So I thought that I would make a part
two. Let's see if this will help me.
Reached over 100,000 subscribers in less than a year. I hit it with like 3 days to spare with my 1 year mark on YouTube. I'm talking way too much, but today I'm going to talk to you guys about how to start a YouTube channel, how to maybe start a successful YouTube channel, and just talking about my journey, and hopefully I can help you guys start your channel.
I'm gonna do these stuff starting the next time I make a video.
Necessary to do if you want to be successful or just want to have fun on YouTube. I remember when I had literally 400 subscribers and Too Simple, Paula, I still love you. You are still my greatest, best, first ever YouTube friend. We started talking through messages, and literally still to this day, we comment on each other's videos and we Snapchat each other, and we're just amazing friends. Collab videos are a great way to make friendships stronger and work on a project with somebody else and get to know them a little bit better, because you're spending so much time on your video, and then when you get to see theirs, it's just like a really good experience. Also, when you collab, you can maybe swap phone numbers. This may be a little bit scary when you first start your channel. When I first started my channel and I did my first collab where we swapped phone numbers, it was like the weirdest thing ever. But now that I'm texting YouTubers like my best friends on a daily basis, it's really no big deal. But
I'll probably collab with someone. Maybe if I get big enough.
But if it's like a girl your age and you guys don't make videos, it should be okay to give out your phone number. Just so you guys can, like, you know, talk about your collab and, you know, when you're gonna upload and all these dates. And it just makes your friendship stronger. So your biggest question may be, how do I reach out to YouTubers? And this is an extremely hard thing, even for myself, because even if somebody has, you know, maybe 50,000 subscribers and I have more than them, when I like reach out to them, they don't know that. They just see me being me, saying, hey, you're really cool, we should talk more. You get these messages a lot. The more you grow on YouTube, you get them even more. So how do you make yourself stand out from other people, you know, that just want to be your friend? Twitter is the greatest place to make friends. If I were to give you the biggest advice on how to reach out to a YouTuber, it's not tweeting them being like, hey, oh my god, I love you, you're the best, like, let's, like, please follow me. Like, that's not the way to make friends with somebody. When you tweet at somebody saying, hey, please follow me, I love you, it's really sweet, but it's not a good act of friendship. It automatically puts you, like, beneath the person because you're like, oh my god, please follow me. Whereas if you just said, like, hey girl, just saw your videos, love them, or maybe you ask them a question like, hey, what camera do you use?
I loved it. Or, hey, what song
did you use in this video? Your videos are super cool. I just found them. That's something that puts you in a position that's like, hey, she may be another YouTuber. She sounds like a really genuine and cool person versus somebody that's like, oh my god, I love you to death. Oh my god, like, let's be best friends. And don't get me wrong, I love, love, love getting tweets from you guys that are just like, hey, Ava, oh my god, I love you.
They make my heart feel
so good inside. But if you ever want to become like a YouTube friend, I would just ask me like a YouTube question through Twitter, or maybe say like, I'm a YouTuber too. So yeah, if you ever wanted to make friends with a YouTuber, I would reach out to somebody that, number one, has around the same number of subscribers as you, and number two, reach out to them on Twitter, and number three, reach out to them through a question about YouTube, or just say, you know, like, hey girl, I'm a YouTuber too, we should talk more. Great way to do it. So lighting is another thing that I wanted to talk about, because I talked about it in my last video. What I do is I genuinely film from 8 a.m. to about 1 o'clock p.m. because after that the sunlight is way too It's a really ugly, like, scene to see. It's just like a big white. You can't even see my face.
Yeah.
So you have to kind of figure out and adjust your filming times. You may have to wake up earlier, depending on where you live.
Yeah.
The lighting, which is throughout the day. You don't want to film when it's dark outside and you have no lighting
because the video will be just terrible quality. So what I do through 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. is I go in front of a window like I am right now, and I wait to where the sun is in that perfect position where the sun is out, but it's not coming through the window because that's way too harsh of light. I put my curtains through, like I spread my curtains throughout the window, and I pull the blinds aside, and that's the perfect lighting. That's what you're seeing right now. No studio lights. It's not, you know, fancy schmancy expensive. I just use natural lighting, and you guys can too. You guys don't need expensive lighting. A lot of you guys would ask me what Sigma lens. When people ask me the question in my comments, what camera do I use? Literally, I hate telling them what camera I use because then they think, oh, if I buy this camera, it'll be the same video quality as Ava. That's not true. What you guys need to do is buy a good lens. Invest in a good lens. The lens that I'm using is the same lens that Miss Glamorazzi uses, Mandy, Makeup by Mandy uses, Alicia, MacBaby11. Recently, a bunch of YouTubers have really been getting into this lens. It's $520 retail, but do not buy for $520. I got mine off of Amazon for like $320, I think. If you're serious about YouTube, I would get it. This is probably my greatest investment on YouTube was this lens, and it has helped me out so much. So when you see my lookbook videos, they're super professional quality, and the lighting is beautiful, and it's got that blurry background. It's all the